Assalamu alaikum class, today I am going to discuss the digestion in the cockroach. Here you can see the diagram of the digestive system of the cockroach. This is the head of the cockroach. Actually, this is literally dissected cockroach. This is the esophagus. Here salivary glands are the present. This is the crop. These are hepatic cecae, gizzard, mesenteron, malpighian tubules, ileum, colon, rectum. These are cerci and these are involved in the sensory perception. The digestive system of the cockroach is tubular type. Its main mouth opening and the anus opening are the separate in case of the cockroach. This digestive system is tubular type. It is divided into three divisions. First one is the foregut, second one is the midgut, and third one is the hindgut. In foregut, mouth cavity, pharynx, crop and gizzard are included. Mouth cavity, pharynx, crop and gizzard, these are included in the foregut. This is the division of the foregut. In hindgut, a salivary gland is present in the region of the thorax, and this produces saliva which mixes with the food. When it comes from the mouth parts are here. Chewing mouth parts and mandibles are strong for the purpose of the chewing of food. Okay, next one is the midgut is short and narrow tubule called the mesenteron. This is the midgut. Short and narrow tubules are called mesenteron. Stomach short finger-like hollow tubules called the hepatic cecum. They open into the anterior of the midgut. Anterior portion of the midgut is this one, and these hepatic cecum enter into the anterior portion of the midgut, that is the mesenteron. The hindgut is a long coiled tubule, and at the terminal part of is a thicker chamber present, which is called rectum. Here you can see that these are long coiled tubules, and the terminal part is the broader, and this is known as the rectum, and it opens through anus outside the body. Cockroaches are omnivorous. They can eat all type of the food. Your common observation, you can see that they eat sputum, they eat all the materials present in your homes. For the cutting of food, they use their strong mandibles. Mandibles are the jaws. They cut food particles into the smaller pieces, and then after, these salivary glands releases the saliva which contain enzyme for the digestion of the carbohydrates. Then food is passed into the crop, and crop is a temporarily storage organ for the food. Food leaves the crop chunk by chunk and enter into the gizzard. Gizzard is the grinding structure of the food. Then hepatic cecae releases the enzymes which are mixed with the food, and in midgut digestion of food is completed. The indigestible food after temporary storage in the rectum then remove out from the body. Cockroach have a complete digestive tract. Mouth opening and the anal opening in case of cockroaches are separate. So this is the advancement in the digestive tract. In the previous topics, planaria, in case of planaria, there is a single opening for entry and the ejection of the waste material from the body. In case of amoeba, there is no digestive system. However, in cockroach, there is a separate opening for mouth and anus. This is included in the invertebrate. Next to the cockroach is the vertebrate, and they have well-defined digestive tracks. This is the completion of the topic. Thank you, class.